and thank you for your wonderful welcome. I'm certainly happy to be back with all you nice people again. And I'm going to open my show tonight with a number that's kind of a classic with me. I call it Tchaikovsky's 12th Street Rag. Play the 12th Street Rag, but I changed it. I changed it and made it faster because that's the way I find my friends like to hear it. And Robert Ripley even referred to this new version in his Believe It or Not one day. He said there were 6,000 notes in it that were played in 2 minutes' time. And the only reason I mentioned it is because I thought you might like to count the notes as I play it. I'll be back in just a moment, but right now, I want you to hear this very important announcement from our sponsors. Incidentally, if any of Tchaikovsky's relatives were listening to that last number, I want them to know I was only kidding. I know it was written by a man named Bowman. Well, all kidding aside, I'd like to do a number by a Polish composer now. His name is Szarbenka. And he wrote a very delightful little dance called the Polish National Dance. And it's the kind of music they play at Polish weddings. And the reason I seem to know about this sort of thing is because I'm half Polish. I have a Polish mother, and that's why I know about it. Incidentally, George, will you tell your musicians if they play the accompaniment real nice that the next time I get an offer for a Polish wedding, they can come along, okay? Doesn't pay much money, but all you can eat and drink, they're wonderful.
Thank you.
received a request in the mail asking me to play Tenderly. And I think they mean the song by Walter Gross. And I'll try to play it tenderly, okay?
Thank you.
relaxing. That's music by Tchaikovsky. And it certainly is beautiful music and very popular with our present generation. And it seems hard to believe that this beautiful music was very unpopular during Tchaikovsky's generation. He lived for even a faint word of praise, which never came to him. He corresponded with a woman for 13 years that he never actually met. And she was the only one who encouraged Tchaikovsky in his music. It wasn't until he was in his 50s, when he came to America to open the famed Carnegie Hall, that Tchaikovsky experienced his first happiness. The Americans greeted him with open arms and loved his music, and he had hoped someday to return to America where he might spend the rest of his days. But his tours took him back to Europe and into a plague-infested area where one day, while writing a composition, he carelessly drank a glass of unboiled water and died within a few hours. The music that we best remember Tchaikovsky by is his famous concerto in B-flat minor. Thank you. been fascinated by this folk song here because it comes from the people, and every generation has added some little variation to this song, and I would like to add a few variations of my own right now to that wonderful folk song, O Chichornya, Dark Eyes. Looking forward to our next.